You don't hear much from Melania Trump these days. That's okay. She's a mom. She's got some time. Guys, it was a wild 4 years, so totally get it. Take your time, Melania. But the world is waiting to hear from you. Let me just say, I loved this story from this weekend. Melania Trump finally creeping back out there and dropping some bombs. It's amazing. She's such a sweet and graceful person. But when she goes after the left for their lies, it is a thing of beauty. Melania Trump herself is a thing of beauty, a superstar, a supermodel, and someone who was treated just so cruelly in the White House. It was wicked. But it's about time for Melania to stand up for herself, and we are so proud of her for going after the fake news reporter Michael Bellacos, I believe of the New York Times, tweeted a photo of Melania's Rose Garden redesign. You may remember Melania redesigned the Rose Garden in the White House, very important garden in American history, has been sort of served as the garden of the First Lady for a very long time. Melania Trump did a big renovation of it. He tweeted out a photo, this man from the New York Times, Michael Bellacos. Let me just check and make sure. It looks like NBC News presidential historian, so correcting that. NBC News presidential historian and PBS, so naturally, and PBS, yeah. He said, evisceration of the White House Rose Garden was completed a year ago, this month, calling Melania's refurbishing of the White House Rose Garden a evisceration. That's the word he used. And here was the grim results. Decades of American history made to despair. He tweets a photo then that looks kind of barren. Weirdly, this guy is totally fake news, and Melania calls him on that. Melania, the office of Melania Trump, tweets at him saying, Michael Bellacos has proven his ignorance, showing a picture of the Rose Garden in its infancy. Rose Garden is graced with a healthy and colorful blossoming of roses. His misleading information is dishonorable. He should never be trusted as a professional historian. I love it when Melania Trump finally goes in, right? When you finally hit a nerve. Obviously, she has taken so many attacks in the White House. What these people did to her, what these vicious gremlins did to her, is unspeakable. It's so evil. It's so wrong. It's so partisan. These hacks know no bounds. But this is a thing of beauty. And it's wonderful to watch Melania take a step back. And even with the kind of grace that you come to expect from her, like, drop the hammer on the liberal press. She did this one time. That was my favorite time during her presidency. It was with ABC News in a report about her jacket that said, I don't really care, do you, on the back of it. And ABC News asked her about it, and she had this savage line. Watch.
You know, I often asking myself, if I would not wear that jacket, if I would have so much media coverage. It's obvious I didn't wear the jacket for the children. I wore the jacket to go on the plane and off the plane. And it was for the people and for the left-wing media who are criticizing me, and I want to show them that I don't care. You could criticize whatever you want to say, but it will not stop me to do what I feel it's right.